Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 Beta 8 is probably the last beta. On Tuesday, usually after the Apple event, we should get the release candidate. Now last year we actually had 8 betas. We had iOS 14 Beta 8, which released after the announcement of the event. They didn't do that this year with Beta 9, but instead we have Beta 8, and it looks like we've had it for about 2 weeks. I've been running it full time on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, which is my main phone. I also have it on the iPhone 11 right here, and an iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021, the M1 iPad Pro. And so with iOS 15, I wanted to talk about its overall stability so far, since it should be out to the public fairly soon. I'll talk a little bit more about that later on, but it seems like it's fairly stable for most people. Not everyone is going to have the same experience, but for a lot of people it seems to be pretty good. And iOS 15 is more of a update that fixes a lot of little things and sort of has stability and small upgrades. Keep in mind, people have been working from home programming iOS 15 to be what it is today, and so they've added a lot of things that people have wanted for quite some time and just refined things. There's actually about 350 to 400 total changes in this update, even though a lot are not super visual, like the weather app and the widget. So this has been updated quite nicely, but a lot of things have not changed visually compared to iOS 14. And some people are seeing apps updated finally for their banking apps. So I saw some this morning from Germany where it says it supports iOS 15. So if you were having those issues, finally it should be working with your phone. Just make sure that the update is there. Apple is allowing them to go through now, which makes me think we'll see iOS 15 released to the public probably sometime next week. Generally, when an update comes out, you'll see today the 10th when I'm recording this, and usually the event is on the 14th, we'll see the release candidate, and if they do what they did last year, we had the release the following day. However, we could see it sometime later in the week or even the following week. So it's just really hard to say what Apple's actually going to do, but it seems like that's what they've been doing for the past couple of years and they could continue doing now. Now with iOS 15 Beta 8, there's quite a few things that are working great at this point, but there's still people that are having issues with quite a few little things all throughout the OS. Now, one way I was able to resolve most of that for me is by resetting all the settings on the phone. So I've talked about this in a few different videos, and if you go to your settings, then general, then go down to transfer or reset iPhone, then go to reset. Reset all settings actually fixed a lot of issues I was having. Everything from odd connectivity issues to just crashes and things like that. Now it is a bit of a pain because you'll have to set up your network settings again and basically any setting you had, such as background app refresh and things like that. You'll have to reset all your notification settings. So it's a bit of a pain to do, but it did fix a lot of issues I was having. And I've heard this from other people that have reset it. So everything from odd Bluetooth connectivity issues and everything else, it seems to resolve those issues for a lot of people. So for me, it seems like Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are fixed once I did that. Before I did that, there were some strange issues, but so far it's been pretty good. And performance has been quite good as well. Now there are some bugs I'll talk about in a moment, but performance overall has been great, even on older phones. So with the iPhone 11, which isn't too old, but if you have an iPhone 6S or iPhone 6S Plus, you're still going to have decent performance, whether that's scrolling or going into apps like music, having that load. And you'll see I don't have any connection on this device right now since I'm outside, but in general, it seems to be pretty decent overall for most people as far as performance compared to iOS 14. I wouldn't say there's any degradation in performance, and it seems to be about the same. So as far as those issues, they seem to be pretty good. Now there is an issue with storage that some people are seeing quite a bit. So if you go into your settings and you go to general and then you go and look at your iPhone storage, quite a few people are seeing an odd storage bug where they could have it taking up many, many gigabytes. And so I'm waiting for it to load here. We'll give it just a moment. Now it took a little bit of time to calculate the storage, but quite a few people are having issues with other or system and things taking up a lot of space. You'll see my system data is at 0 kilobytes. So that's fine for me, but for some people it's taking up a ton of space. And what some people have told me is to reset or clear your cache or history settings in Safari, reboot the phone. This was shared by Elvis on my Telegram server, and if you want to join that, it's in the description. But if you do that and reboot, clear your cache, you can do that by going to your settings, and then in your settings, go down to Safari, Under Safari, scroll down and clear history and website data. Once you do that and reboot, it seems to fix that problem for a lot of people. So I would try that. It will, of course, clear all of your history and website data, but as long as you're okay with that, once you reboot, it seems to fix those storage issues. So that still remains an issue for some. And another issue that some people are having is odd connectivity issues with AirPods. So their AirPods will randomly disconnect. Thankfully, since resetting my settings, that has not been an issue for me at all. So it's doing quite good as far as that goes. Now, as far as other things that are fixed, it seems like connectivity is fixed this time. Now, I'm still on beta 8 like I was before, and my 4G to 5G switching seems to be working just fine. Before, when I would go to different websites and things, it just wouldn't load. After this week, it seems to be okay. So for some reason, it's much, much better. So now if I go into Safari and we're at Apple and I tap on Learn More, you'll see everything's loading pretty reasonably. So I haven't really had any issues as far as that goes. It seems to load just fine. If I go back, go to something else and load it, it seems to be nice and fast like you would expect. So the connectivity issues have gone away for me. I don't know if that was a T-Mobile issue or something else or carrier dependent, but it definitely seems to have made a difference between last week and this week. Now, some other people are having other issues such as odd scrolling bugs. So when you're scrolling, sometimes it will be stuttery or lock up. Other people cannot play back videos on YouTube, on Safari, where it would just sort of stutter or give a blank screen. It was fixed in beta 7, but people are still having that issue in beta 8 now. Also, some people have said FaceTime is giving them an issue with disconnects. I've seen that a couple times, even since the past week or so. I'll be using FaceTime with a call with a family member and then it just hangs up. So there's some odd issues, usually with the initial connection. Now also, some people are still not seeing live text where you can select text within photos. And this is a screenshot someone sent me of their updated banking app, but you can see it says iOS 15 compatibility, but it's in German. But you see I can select the text. Some people are not able to do this even if they have a supported device. That feature is not available on all devices, but most people that are having this issue, you need to change your settings to English and then it will show up. It's not supported in all languages from what many people are telling me. They're only seeing it in English, and Apple does say they don't support it on every language just yet, so it will be coming later on. Other people are having odd brightness issues. I had this early on. I don't seem to have it now, but the brightness issues seem to be resolved. I don't know if it just took a while to sort of fix itself after it finished doing things in the background. And notifications are getting stuck for some people. Now, it's been resolved for me. Last week, I reported that the notification badge was just not accurate. Some people have been saying it's just because your focus modes are on. And for me, that wasn't the case. Sometimes it just wasn't checking mail regularly. So I updated some of my settings in mail and things seem to be resolved now. So there's definitely some odd issues still going on. I don't think most of those are major. The cellular issues obviously are major. And if you're still having issues with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and for some reason, with early betas of iOS 15, all of a sudden Bluetooth was a problem. It wasn't before, so maybe they changed something and hopefully they fix this in the future. Now, as far as the heat of the device, some people are still reporting the device getting warm. Right now, it's about 73 degrees as far as the outside temperature, you can see here, and the phone is a little bit warm, but that's because I'm at full brightness recording this. If it was 90 degrees out Fahrenheit, the phone would get hot enough where it would dim the screen. This seems to be a continued issue, and it's probably an issue with the chipset itself. So hopefully iPhone 13 resolves this with maybe better cooling, as is rumored with that upcoming iPhone. Also, green tint is still an issue for some, and at this point, Apple has not resolved it. We've seen no iOS 14.8, and they've resolved it by this time last year with the iPhone 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max, and so far we have nothing as far as that goes this year, so it makes me think it might be more hardware related for those that are experiencing it. Thankfully, none of my iPhone 12 models, the 12 mini, 12, 12 Pro, or 12 Pro Max, have experienced it, and I haven't seen it personally in person, only from people sending that to me. I haven't seen it myself, but it does continue to be a problem for some people. Now, as far as overall battery life on this phone, I've been using it full time, like I said. So if we go to my battery and battery health, I'm down to 94%. It hasn't dropped for the past few betas. And if we look at the last 10 days, yesterday I only had 2 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 4 minutes of screen off time. A lot of that is playing music and things in the background. If we look at today, 1 hour and 44 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 14 minutes of screen off time. In both cases, I used 40 to 50% battery life, so that's not that great. But you'll see the day before, I had 50% usage. Here you can see 50% and 3 hours and 20 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 28 minutes of screen off time with 50% usage. That means if we double these numbers and I used it to 100%, we'd have about 7 hours of screen on time and 10 to 11 hours of screen off time. So that's actually quite good. Most people are getting the 8 to 10 hours of screen on time you would expect from a 12 Pro Max. If you have an 11 Pro Max, it might be even a little bit more. It just depends on your usage habits. If you're using games regularly, you're going to have worse battery life. If you're just using Twitter and things like that, you'll probably have better battery life. So it really depends on what you're using. But let's take a look at the iPad battery as well. Now with the iPad, if we go to my settings and then we go down to battery, I had this charged to 100% last night, 1 hour ago, up until this morning, and I've been getting about 6 hours of screen on time. You can see that here, 4 hours and 8 minutes of screen on time, 28 minutes of screen off time. So I'm getting about 6 to 8 hours. My iPad battery life has been really odd lately, so I do expect it to improve with the final version, but I may have to reset all settings again on this or try and wipe it again to get that 10 hours. But it just depends what you're doing. I do use it a lot for YouTube. But overall, the iPad has been super stable and I've had no issues with it whatsoever. Now, as far as if you should install this update, many people have been asking me, they want to try out iOS 15. And I would say at this point, if you're concerned about bugs and any additional issues remaining, maybe battery life, I'd probably just hold off until next week or so when we'll probably have it released to the public. Usually on the 15th to the 17th, I would expect it. However, it could be something different depending on what Apple decides to do this year. But generally, based off of year over year, it should be this coming week or the following week at the latest, but probably this week after the event. Usually the next day or the next few days, we'll have the final version released to the public with iOS 15, iPadOS 15, watchOS 8, and HomePodOS 15 and tvOS 15. All of those should be out around the same time. I would expect Apple to delay macOS maybe a few more weeks like they normally do. So that's typically something they do with this. So if you wanna try it out, you could do that. Just make sure you have a backup and have a computer to restore if you need to do that. You need Windows or a Mac in order to restore with iTunes or Finder. Otherwise, definitely try it out. It seems to be fairly stable for most people at this point. Now, as far as the overall Apple event, well, that Apple event is going to be on Tuesday. We should see the new iPhones, probably a new Apple Watch, and we'll have that as well. So look forward to that. Of course, as soon as I know more about that and we hear everything, I'll have a video about it as well, and we'll talk about what's new as far as that Apple event. But that event should be on the 14th at 10 a.m. Pacific time or 1 p.m. Eastern. I'll be watching it live, and you can watch it on Apple.com or YouTube. And so be sure to check that out if you have the option to watch it live. It's always great to see what Apple's announcing. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll, it's been 2 weeks or a little over a week now since it's been out. And let's load that. And RAM management, that just reloaded. You saw that I wasn't in YouTube the entire time of the video. So over the past few 10, 15 minutes, it's reloaded. And you'll see it's been active for about a week with 39,000 votes and 388 comments. So 34% of you are on the beta already, down up from 33% the previous week, and 53% of you are still holding out for that final version, or maybe you won't update altogether. It does look like Apple's going to give you the option to stay on iOS 14 permanently if you want to do that with security updates. So that seems to be a little bit different. As far as the overall community poll and the comments on the poll, let's take a look at some of them. I looked at some last week. Let's take a look at some of the newer ones. Sage says, I have beta 8 on both my devices. On my iPad Pro 12.9 fourth gen, the battery life is abysmal. It goes to 70% in less than 2 hours, which is so bad. Typically, I don't recommend measuring battery life from the time it goes down from 100 to 70, as it's not really linear. I would try it over the course of a day till you get it down to about 10% or so. My iPhone 12 Pro Max is great and it's really smooth too, but saving photos from the messaging app doesn't work on occasions. That's my only bug at this moment. Jagged637 says, everything is running quick and smooth, but I notice the back getting very hot when watching certain video apps, ESPN, especially when using picture-in-picture. Slowwave said, on iOS 15 Beta 8, iPhone 11, apps that were crashing isn't having problems anymore, but the problem is the data network got slower than before. Matt Barton says, overall pretty stable and good battery life on my iPhone 12. Only issue I've noticed is when live listen, when connected to my AirPods Pro, the feature fails to turn off. even when the screen states they are turned off. Chief Dan says still having horrible battery drain, but overall not too bad. My iPhone isn't heating up like it did on Beta 7, and nothing has crashed. iPhone 12 Pro Max. They just need to finally address the battery drain, and then everything will be perfect. Trepalium says I'm on iOS 15 Beta 8 on a regular original 12. It has never ran worse. Almost every app I'm using is crashing or freezing. Battery is needed to be charged nearly twice a day, from barely charging once a day, along with links refusing to open and pages on Safari only loading partially. Also on tvOS, AirPlay is running terribly. I haven't had a single issue on any of the betas until now. I've updated every time and it's basically been flawless, which is a bit concerning considering this is most likely the last update before release. Now, like I said before, if you're having weird issues like that, I find that resetting all settings fixes all those issues. It's a pain to do, but it definitely seems to help. Charles Davis says, battery life has been improved on my iPhone XR. Not so well on my SE 2020. AJ Prime Tech says, battery life has been fine on my iPhone X and stability has been great. Cardi Tech says, I'm on iOS 15 Beta 8 with iPhone 7 Plus and I don't like that some features are missing, but I think there is a way. Some features are not available on the 7 Plus. I did a separate video about that because if you have an A12 Bionic or newer, you'll have certain features. If you don't, you won't have those features. So just keep that in mind. It's sort of highlighted on their iOS 15 page, unfortunately. James says, seems to be doing well overall, no major issues, and the battery life does well. I'm using the 12 Pro Max. Aaron Trous says, iOS 15 Public Beta 8 on 12 Pro Max feels somewhat more refined as snappier, and I've seen a big improvement to battery life. The phone appears to run cooler as well. And finally, Andrew says, I'm on Beta 8 now, really stable, 12 mini and iPad 8 here. And so that's everything with iOS 15 Beta 8. Of course, we should see the release candidate and final release very soon. I'm looking forward to that, and of course, that Apple event with the new iPhones and more. I can't believe we're already at that point in the year. It seems like just yesterday they announced the 12 Pro and the 12 Pro Max, but here we are again, and with new iOS updates and more. We'll see more features as well with iOS 15.1 once we get into those betas, but let me know what you're most excited for in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do, and if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.